When we think about the aerospace sector, Singapore's position currently as the top maintenance, repair and overhaul hub in Asia has been something that has been well established. We will continue our strong support for Singapore-based aerospace companies, enabling them to not only excel in their traditional areas of strength, but to be ready to tap on emerging opportunities.
This is the only conference on technology in the whole air show. Our speakers are all senior members of the aerospace program and 80% of the commercial aviation companies.
With the Internet of Things, we've collected and analyzed data. You can now go into the prognostic world where you'll be able to predict what's going to happen.
While a lot of the conference was about technology, technology comes from people's brains. And so it's really about, will we have the right brain power with the right skills when we need it as we go forward to make all these great new enhancements happen?
We were very happy to work with A-Star to set up the ARTC. Its focus is primarily on remanufacturing, that is repair technology, which is good for the environment because you're not throwing things away and wasting materials.
We got to be willing as companies to invest in those kind of technologies. And, you know, 90% of those won't turn out to be anything, but the few that do will be those game changers.
We also have to be very mindful of what is happening at else part of the world, how we can form joint ventures with overseas companies, technology leaders, to bring the technology into Singapore.
The other interface we have with A-Star is through the IHPC, where we have a joint laboratory looking at high power computing, both in the modeling of our engines, so the modeling for the future, how they perform, but also this big data question of how we break down data from service, understand it, and how we can then provide a better service to our customers based on that data.
We will continue to leverage R&D and innovation. We will see the Singapore government invest $3.3 billion in advanced manufacturing and engineering public R&D capabilities over the next 5 years.